Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Can I Beat? The series in which I take on the game show games of yesteryear and see if I can win. And today we're playing Hollywood Squares on the NES from 1988. Made by Rare as well, look at that. Audio visual by Rare Limited, wow. I don't really know anything about Hollywood Squares, apart from a brief clip from The Simpsons. And also there's that bit I saw on YouTube with Gilbert Gottfried playing it and he kept on saying, That's it. So I think celebrities will give answers to questions and I have to agree with them or disagree and that's how I get points. Oh, the music stopped. Let's just get on with it. But yeah, hopefully that's enough to know to try and win. Right, so how many contestants? Just one. Would you like a new player character? A new character, player one. Yes. That doesn't really look like me. Ooh. Oh, look at this cool dude with some sunglasses on. Oh, yeah. No. Okay, it's just that. Oh, we'll stick with this guy then. Enter name. Okay, let's be Muck. What a lovely tune that is. Not at all grating on the ears. Oh, I typed Luck. Well, that'll work as well. That'll do. Oh my god, we're up against Pam. That's weird. Okay. So these are the celebrities we have to pick from. I guess they're not actual celebrities from 1988. What a shame. Oh, there's me, Joe. Val, Sam, Ruth, Dean, Sue, Eddie, May, and Mike. Well, let's go with me first. Joe's question. According to Self magazine, is giving in to your partner a good way to keep a relationship going? That doesn't sound very healthy to me. Do I have to press something? Only if the gun is loaded. Joe's answer is no. I'm going to agree. That seems like a bad way to have a relationship. And I was right. Take that, Pam. Okay, Pam is picking Mike. There's a company that now makes disposable telephones. Who are they primarily for? Drug dealers. Is that the thing? Is it like how the celebrity always has a funny quip to say, but then actually gives an answer? Do I have to carry on for Pam? For people who never return phone calls. Construction workers? Wrong. Hospitals to protect patients from germs, you silly, silly Pam, you. Okay, so. Oh, and we get the point for that, I'm guessing. So is it like connect? Is it like noughts and crosses? So do I need to go down here to try and get a line? Is that how it works? Come on, Dean, with your spiky hair. According to Parents magazine, why do I keep getting magazine ones? Children who were subjected to this kind of light had more cavities, more absences from school, and were more misbehaved. What kind of light? Budweiser. Oh, Dean. Incandescent light. Agree. It's 1988, sure. Wrong. It was fluorescent. Damn it. Does that mean that Pam gets... Oh, Pam gets that one now, of course. Right, okay then. According to a study at Emory University, what is the normal amount of hairs that a woman should lose daily? As many grey ones as she can pull out. Hey, come on, Eddie. You can't say that. 25? 100 hairs a day fall out? Oh, we could win here. Let's go down here. Come on, Sam. Juliet Lowe started it in 1912 with 18 girls. To date, more than 50 million of them have participated. What is it? It's going to be the Girl Scouts, isn't it? Or whatever it is in America. Making their husbands miserable. Jeez, oh my. It's just, oh. The YWCA. I don't know what that stands for, but I'm going to agree. Oh, it was the Girl Scouts. Damn it. I didn't know whether that was like an acronym for it or something. No, Pam might win if she goes with the granny. You better not win, Pam. According to the Dictionary of Scriptures and Myths, when you hear the voice of God, you are really hearing what? Memorex? I don't get that, Ruth. The darkest fears. Pam agrees. Wrong. It's your conscience. Of course it is. Right, so that means we need to go here and we need to win this. If we don't get this right, then it's going to be a tie. So, come on, May. True or false? In Russia, if a woman gives birth to more than 10 children, she is rewarded with cash and prizes. What are these questions? And a chance to win one of 5 beautiful tractors. That's... oh, true. It's called the Mother Heroine Award. That's got to be false, right? It's true! Crazy Russians. Oh, man. So, what happens now? Because we can't make a line. President Kennedy's father said, the way to avoid being intimidated by businessmen is to picture them in what? Nothing? In drag, okay. In the kitchen? No. Of course it's underwear. I would have thought nude, but the way they worded that, yeah. Alright, so we can only go with... oh wait, or can we turn? No, wait, I can still win if I go with Sue. Come on, Sue. For the win, according to the World Book... what's the World Book? Billy the Kid was 15 years old when the first time he did it. Did what? It's going to be, what, Billy the Kid? That was a cowboy, wasn't it? So, was toilet trained? Oh, Sue. He got married at... oh, probably. Probably. He shot his first man. That makes more sense with the cowboy stuff. So, no one won. Great. What a waste of time. Right, Pam's starting first. We are winning on points, though, at least. Find the secret square for an amazing prize, did that say? Pam picked me! Oh, Pam! According to Greek mythology, who was the first woman on Earth? Okay. But it wasn't Eve. George Burns' mother? I would say that. That is something I would say. Joe's answer, it's Pandora. She was created by Zeus. Okay, she was right as well. Damn. We're going to go with Sam down here. You take the eggs from a sturgeon, rub them through a screen, wash them, rub them with salt, drain, and then dry them. What do you get? Eggs, and then you rub them through a screen, wash them, dry. I don't know. Fishy buckshot. Wax. No. No, I disagree with that. You get caviar, of course. Right. Where are you going to go, Pam? You're going to go with Mike. According to the medical section of the Los Angeles Daily News, the most frequent ways colds are spread is by... coughing? Trying to wash and reuse your Kleenex? touching, yeah, that makes sense. Pam's on a roll this round. I gotta go here or she wins. Egyptian mummies were found wearing them. The ancient Greeks and Romans wore them. So did the French in the 17th century, who powdered theirs. What were they all wearing? The same underwear for a week. Stockings. Would you powder stockings? I disagree. It was wigs. Yes, powdered wigs, of course. Where are you going, Pam? Oh, I see. I see. You're trying to screw me over, are you? What famous thing ran all the way from St. Joseph, Missouri to Sacramento, California? Some sort of root. Shelley Winters nylons. Ruth, you can't say that. Santa Fe Trail. No, that's right. No, damn it, it's wrong. It was the Pony Express. Oh, no. She's just screwed me over. That means I've got to go here. When can you tell that a young duckling has finally matured? When it gets all angsty. When it learns to keep its beak shut at meetings. It gets new feathers. That makes sense. Yeah, let's go with that. Great. So where's Pam going to go? Pam's going up there for some reason. I guess we can't win now again. They are extremely bloodthirsty, travel in groups, and have been known to tear the flesh off skeletons of animals and people in just a few minutes. What are they? Piranhas? Divorce lawyers. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. It's piranha fish, yeah. What? Why would you disagree with that, Pam, you silly bint? Can we... We can't... Oh, we can still win. Come on, Sue. Adam and Eve wore the world's first clothes. What were they made out of? Leaves, right? Isn't that the picture? They have leaves over there? Designer foliage. Skins of animals. I mean, that would... No. It was skins of animals. Damn it! I haven't read the Bible. No, Pam's gonna win. And she found the secret square. A correct answer wins a vacation retreat to the Bavarian castle. Okay. Well, she would love that, I'm sure. Oh, please do not get this right, Pam. According to the World Book, if you can perform downs and ops, egg in a basket and upcast and downcast, what are you good at? Eggs in a, I don't know, some sort of dance? Operating an elevator for chickens. Jacks. No! She won! No! Well, no, do you know what? Good for her. Pam has won a vacation retreat to a Bavarian castle. I would have loved that, but she can have it. Coming in, round three. There is a round three. Okay, yeah, good. Here we go. Got to get that middle square. I've got to pick me. According to the language of the Old West, what did it mean when a cowboy sold his saddle? These questions, man. He lost his money and horse in a poker game? He was disgraced. I would agree with that. That sounds right. Great. Okay, we've got the middle square, which does help quite a lot. Pam's going with Mike. Sarah Ferguson just spent 4 weeks studying so she could do it by herself, and Prince Andrew was delighted. Let's not have any questions about this guy, can we? Please. What did she do? She made instant coffee. Ha 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 ha, yeah. Sailed the family yacht. Wrong. She flew solo in an airplane. Oh, okay. All right. Oh, we could win this so quickly. Of all the birds in the world, only one has two toes. Which is it? Oh, two toes? The ones in the Gucci shoes? An ostrich. Doesn't an ostrich have more than that? I think an ostrich has more than that. Disagree. It was an ostrich. No, why do I always get the one I need wrong? Oh, she's going to go up there, isn't she? Yeah, she's going with Eddie. Would you eat a tenderpod bush snap? It sounds a bit like a pea or something. I'd sooner swallow my mouthpiece. Eddie says no, Pam agrees. Wrong. It's a bit, yeah, see? It sounds like a bean. So we could win again over here. According to the book Do's and Taboos Around the World, which contains tips for tourists abroad, what does it mean when an Arab grabs your hand? They want to marry you? He's got a watch to sell you. It's an honour, a sign of friendship. I've never heard that, but I've not really been in... Disagree. It is that. Of course it is, because that's what I needed to win, and that's always going to be wrong. Right, she's going to go with Ruth. In the old nursery rhyme, where would you find the butcher, the baker, and the candlestick maker? That, I actually do know the answer to that one. On the original dating game. No, it's going to sea in a pea green boat. No, yeah, it's rub-a-dub-dub, three in a tub. Great. Okay, we can still win. Look at this, we can win two different ways if we get this right. Please, please. True or false? According to the Associated Press, some doctors are now using zippers instead of stitches on surgery patients. No. No, no, no. Come on now. In protest, my tailor is now doing open heart surgery. That's May says false, I agree. What? No! I've never heard that. I've never heard that. That's a lie. That's a big fat lie. Can you teach a pig to fetch? Pigs are actually very smart. Yes, baloney, Kermit's pipe and slippers. Yes, I would agree with that. Oh, Pam disagrees. Yeah, see? Pigs are actually very smart and yet we eat them. And I have them in sausages. Okay, we can still win. Here we go, we're back down to Sue. If you're pregnant, is morning sickness a good sign? Oh. Is it a good sign? A good sign of what? The pregnancy going well? Yeah, it lets you know when you're gonna throw up. Sue says yes. I suppose it does, right? Because that means hopefully the baby is healthy. I agree. Yes! Finally! Finally! Right, it's one all. One apiece. Me against Pam. Oh, I got to pick a key. Lucky number 5. I get to pick a car? Is there a blue one? There's a gold one. Okay, we're going with the blue one. Oh, no, wait. We haven't actually won it yet. Does it open the car? Turn? Damn it. The key doesn't fit. Bad luck, Luck. You have $1,500. Do you wish to continue playing as X? I guess, is that it? Did we lose? Or is it just the end of the round? I'll carry on playing as X. No. That was it. We lost. Because we picked the wrong key to a car. Well, at least we beat Pam. Take that, Pam. But anyway, there's the answer to the question, can I beat Hollywood Squares? The answer is no.